हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी लर्न सर्च इंजन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन। यू नो दैट व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ सर्च इंजन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन। ओके, सर्च इंजन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन इज यूज्ड फॉर मेंटेनिंग द ट्रैफिक ओवर एन इंटरनेट। सपोज यू आर द रेगुलर यूजर ऑफ यूट्यूब एंड यू आर क्रिएटिंग YouTube videos and you are uploading that videos on an internet, at that time you must think that you should be a popular person on YouTube. Okay, for that, when you are uploading that videos to the YouTube, at that time you are using the title and description for the videos. Okay, and what are the titles and descriptions you are providing, on that basis the users or the viewers can view your videos over the YouTube. And to search that videos by giving a keyword by the user on a Google search engine, they will get a specific videos regarding provided keyword. Okay, so for maintaining that traffic over an internet, this search engine optimization is used. Yes, now we are saying that what is meant by optimizing website. So you all are aware of creating of web pages. Okay, after creating a web pages, you are launching that web pages on an internet. Okay, so when you are creating the web page, at that time, at very first, you are using the doc type. It is as HTML. Okay, then you are using the HTML tag. After that HTML tag, you are using head tag. Head tag is used for providing the heading detail to the web page. Okay, then in head tag, you are using the title tag for providing the title to the web page. Then you are closing that title tag, and then you are closing the head tag. Okay, after that, the actual content which we are able to see on the web page, that will be appeared, and that content is provided into body tag. Okay, so this is the procedure for creating web page. And then in body, you are entering the information which you want to display on the web page, and after that you are closing the body, and at final location you are ending the HTML program. Okay, so see, what is the procedure for optimizing the website? There are various sections of website which can be optimized for better search engine optimization. Some of the ways to optimize the web page for SEO are given below. So see, SEO, page structure optimization. Very first, HTML program should start with exclamatory sign, doc type, HTML. Then, if it is singular tag, for example, like img tag, it should be self enclosed. Okay, so we know that img tag is a singular tag. Okay, it do not have a pair like the other tags, such as paragraph tag p and slash paragraph tag p. Here, this img tag do not have that type of peer tag. So it encloses itself in this way, img then slash. Okay. Third, order of tag should be proper. Most of the time, recently open tag will be closed first. Here, you can see that the order of tag should be proper. Means that when you are using one tag and in that tag you are using another tag, at that time you must close the another tag which comes with the parent tag. Okay, so that is called as order of tag should be proper. See, then it is recommended to use title. Now we know that when we are creating the web page, we are using the title tag. Title is the first thing that user notice in search result list, okay, while using Google for searching. Content should be up to 60 characters. Here you can use the content up to 60 characters. Now here the content which will be up to 60 characters, it includes the spaces also. Okay, then there is a meta description tag. While creating a web page, meta description should be used to boost your on-page SEO. Meta description should be between 70 and 160 characters. It also includes the spaces. Okay. Then heading tags. The page should include proper heading tags from H1 to H6 wherever required. Now you will see that when we are creating the web page, at that time that pages contain different types of headings, and that headings are represented with the heading tags, and they contains 6 levels: H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6. Okay, so using these headings level tags, you can provide the heading to the proper location onto the web page. Okay, and the next, image tag with ALT attribute. The ALT attribute gives information about the image. So even if the image does not download, it can make the viewers understand the image related information. Now remember, when you are uploading the image on a web page, and suppose if that image do not load on that page, at that time if you are using the ALT attribute with that img tag, then at least you will see that the name of image. So it helps us to see that which type of image is inserted on the web page. Okay, now see examples of optimizing web pages. Here you can see that doc type HTML, then HTML tag, head tag, title tag, page structure with appropriate order of opening and closing tags, end of title, end of head. So see, this is what proper order of tags. Here you can see that here is the head tag, and in head tag you will see that title tag, and when we see the closing, at that time here you will see that closing of title comes before closing of head. So this is called as proper order of tag. Okay, then here is the body tag. H1, let us understand SEO and H1 tag. So here we are using the heading on a web page. Then paragraph tag P, web page optimization helps for higher ranking in search engines. Okay, B tag, there are number of ways to optimize the pages. I tag, even the social media plays an important role. End of I tag, end of B tag, and end of P tag. And then there is a end of body tag and end of HTML tag. Okay, so here this example ends. But again, you will see that page structure with appropriate order of opening and closing tag. So here you can see that here is the paragraph tag, and in paragraph tag you will see B tag. Okay, and in B tag here you will see I tag. Okay, then there is end of I tag, end of B tag, and end of P tag. So they comes in order, and which comes last, it ends first, then which comes to second last, it comes second lastly, and finally which comes first, it ends at the last. Okay, so this is called as proper order. Then you will note that in the above example, check the ordering of paragraph tag, B tag, and I tag. The innermost tag ends first, followed by the outermost tag. The other basic tag also follow a proper ordering as per HTML structure. Here again you will see that HTML, and at the last you will see closing of HTML. So see, it comes very first and it ends at very last. Okay. Then second example, doc type HTML, HTML head, title, meta tag, and image tag. End of title, meta tag contains name attribute, description, content equal to Statue of Liberty. Meta tag name equal to keywords, content equal to ALT, optimization of image. Again, meta tag name equal to image, content equal to Statue of Liberty. And then closing of head tag, body tag, and in body here H1 tag. Let us understand meta and image for optimization. End of H1 tag, paragraph tag, IMG SRC equal to Statue of Liberty dot JPG equal to Statue of Liberty, ALT equal to Statue of Liberty image. Okay, and here there is a closing of IMG. Then closing of paragraph tag P, closing of body tag, and closing of HTML tag. Okay. So note, here you can see the in the above example, meta tag is used with important and valid keywords related to that image, like the image source as Statue of Liberty and from the view of optimization of IMG tag. Okay. Then second type, SEO keywords. SEO keywords are the important words and phrases related to the developed website content. A list of keywords need to be carefully chosen to optimize the search. Keyword research and analysis is an important part of the search engine optimization as well as search engine marketing. For example, search engine marketing, one can play certain keywords. There are various online keyword planner tools such as Google AdWords keyword planner to shortlist keywords. This is more useful to compare the cost of various keywords if the website designer opts for paid search engine marketing. Here you will see that search engine optimization keywords. Okay, it plays an important role. What is keyword? It plays the important role. And phrases related to the developed website content. A list of keywords need to be carefully chosen to optimize the search keywords. It means that when we are creating a website, at that time we have to provide the tags for which the user can search. Okay, if we are providing the proper keywords as a tag, then any user who search for the particular tags or on that particular keyword, he or she will get the results of that website easily. Okay. Then third, search engine optimization, social bookmarking. Social bookmarking is a powerful tool in promoting website. It is very useful for off-page search engine optimization. Bookmarks are website links that are stored for future references. They are very useful, especially when web pages with long URLs are not easy to remember. Bookmarking service allows you to save, organize, and share bookmarks with other users, etc. External links are the important SEO factors to rank a website higher in search engine. With social bookmarking, you can quickly create high quality backed links. Now, what is meant by bookmark? Now, you have the facility on your browsers. If you are using the Google Chrome, at that time, to the side of your address bar, you can see the star symbol. Okay, and when you click on that star symbol, you will bookmark the particular website. And by bookmarking that website, you can view that website in future very easily. There is no need to type whole URL on the address bar. Okay. So for that purpose, this bookmarking is used. But remember one thing. Here, social bookmarking means you are sharing that bookmarks over a social internet. Many times, most of the users are bookmark the URLs on their browsers and saying it as a bookmark. It is not social bookmarking. For social bookmarking, there are different types of sites such as Dig. Okay, in Dig, you have to log in, and after login you can share the social bookmarking. Okay, then social media optimization. It deals with enhancing the website ranking using interactive communities like Facebook, Twitter, blogs, forums, and so on. When these communities have links to the created website, it builds familiarities and trust about the website. Okay, social media optimization is deals with enhancing the website's ranking. Now see that we know that when we are creating the website, at that time they will get the viewers, but if we are creating only a simple website, then no viewers can provide us the feedback on our websites. But if you are creating interactive websites, then the viewers will provide their feedbacks to your website. They will comment on your website. Okay. So for that purpose, social media optimization is also used. If you are creating your website, you can make the advertisement of your website through the Facebook, through the Twitter. Okay. Then next is next one is backlinks. SEO backlinks are the links on the one website that when clicked take the user to another site. Backlinks are especially valuable for search engine optimization because they contribute to the overall strength and value of the content. They also represent a vote of confidence from one site to another. In short, backlinks to your website are signals to search engines that others are interested to know about the content from your websites. And the other factors for SEO, it contains speed of the website and mobile friendly. Speed of the website. While creating a website, attention is given on the design, content, and as many as visuals as possible. However, all but this can slow down the website and obstruct usability. Okay. Then mobile friendly. Websites mobile friendliness has become a ranking factor for Google. Hence, it is very important to ensure that the created website is mobile friendly for maximum exposure and to improve the website's ranking. Now, remember one thing. Today, near about 70-80% people are using the smartphone. Okay, and the smartphones which the users are using, they are generally mobile friendly for the websites. Okay, so if these websites are mobile friendly, then the smart users can see your sites and they will give their response on your website. So these are the certain factors which are useful for optimizing the website. Okay, thank you.